This is grammar, 문법 in Korean. Today we will study subjects of verb, 씁니다 and 씁니까. This is basic form of verb. However, 씁니까? This is when you ask a question, then you can use this suffix with verb, with the root of verb. Okay, then let's try to read these sentences. 노래가 좋습니까? 노래가 좋습니다. You can read the meaning in English in order to understand more correctly and easily. Okay, then let's see the form. This table, there are two variants, and the first one is with 받침. Then the root of verb and adjective plus 씁니다 and 씁니까. Meanwhile, without 받침, then the root of verb or adjective plus 받침부 and then 미다니까. Okay, then let's try to do this practices. 연습 1 보기와 같이 쓰세요. There is a table here, and you can complete these questions. And the first one, like this example, 먹다. With the root of this, there is 받침, so 먹습니까? 먹습니다. Then, question one. 가다. Let's try this. Yes, there is no 받침, so 갑니까? 갑니다. And the question 2, 듣다. 예스, 듣습니까? 듣습니다. And number 3, 좋아하다. 예스, with the root of this verb, 좋아하. There is no 받침, so 좋아합니까? 좋아합니다. And number 4, 위드 루트 오브 디스 버브 좋다. There is 받침 좋. So 좋습니까? 좋습니다. Be careful. Verb 좋아하다. This means like. Meanwhile, 좋다. This means good. Okay. 좋아하다. This is verb. 좋다. This is adjective. And then the last question, 예쁘다. 예스, yes. 예쁩니까? And 예쁩니다. Okay, then next page. Suffix 을. Shortly, this suffix is suffix of objective. For example, let's read this sentence. 저는 밥을 먹습니다. 저는 this is subject. 는 this is suffix of subject. 밥을 this is objective. 을 because 을 this is subject suffix of objective. And then 먹습니다 verb. You can read the meaning in English. 오케이, okay, then let's see this table. Noun plus suffix 을, 오어를. The first variant with 받침. Then noun plus 을. Meanwhile, without 받침, then noun plus 를. Like these examples. 오케이, okay, then let's try this practice together. 연습 2. 대화를 완성하세요. Question number 1. 지금 무엇을 합니까? Answer to this question. Yes, 한국 노래를. The second one, because there is no 받침 with the known 노래, so 한국 노래를 듣습니다. Question number two. 지금 무엇을 먹습니까? 예스, yes, 빵을. The first one, because we don't know 빵, there is 받침, so 빵을 먹습니다. Okay. And then one more grammar suffix 도. Shortly speaking, 도 means to or as well in English. To or either or as well. For example, this sentence is 한국 노래를 좋아합니다. 한국 음식도 좋아합니다. 저도 한국 음식을 좋아합니다. 음식도. This means food also. Food too. 저도. This means I also. Me too. Like me too. Okay? You can read the meaning in English so as to understand better. 오케이, okay, then let's see this table. With 받침 or without 받침, always noun plus 도. Understood? Then let's try this practice. 연습 3. 문장을 완성하세요. Question number 1. 저는 학생입니다. 쯔영 씨, yes, 도 학생입니다. Question number 2. 리사 씨는 빵을 먹습니다. 그리고 과자, yes, 과자 도 먹습니다. 빵을, this object. 과자도, this means 과자 too, 과자 as well. In English, 과자 means snack, chips, chocolate, and so on. This means all. Of course, we have words like snack, chips, chocolate, but 과자 includes all of this. Okay. And then there is some more practices. You can try this as well. And this listening and speaking, you can try this too. Okay. And you can listen this dialogue and then answer the questions at the next page. Okay.